two big summer signings. Dennis Wise comes in from Wimbledon. And fresh from the World Cup, Irish international Andy Townsend.
Well, Dennis, he's a quality midfield player, wide midfield player. There's not many about who can do his job the way he does when he's at the business. He's a specialist at it. And Andy, in my opinion, is a complete midfield player. He can win the ball, he can pass the ball, he can support the ball, and he can go and score goals as well. So he is another very good player.
The sale of Clive Wilson to Queen's Park Rangers brings some money back into the club, but it's a fraction of that invested in new talent. So expectations high as the season begins. First day opponents, Derby County.
Wise with the corner. And it's over the line, yes! Linesman has signalled that it's a goal. Roger Milford wants to give a penalty. Now what's going to happen here? We're 4 minutes into the new season. Have Chelsea got their first goal? They have! Well, the ball certainly didn't reach the back of the net. Kevin Wilson with the first flick. Finally at the far post, David Lee, and although Gary Micklewhite tried to stop it, it's a goal. Now Ramage, getting away from Nicholas, who tries to get a tackle in, but the ball's broken for Dean Saunders, and Derby have come out for the second half and scored straight away, 1-1. 14 minutes to go. Wise against the post, past Dixon, it's Nicholas, Chelsea are back in front, Shilton is furious, and the captain has come up with a spectacular shot after Dennis Wise nearly marked his debut with a free kick that was so close to giving Chelsea the lead, but it was only seconds away from them, from Nicholas. Harford, Ramage, it's a penalty, Micklewhite thought he'd scored, Roger Milford had already blown, and here we are in the final minute, Dean Saunders, and Besant stopped it, Chelsea have an opening day hero, it's their goalkeeper, and they've won the game. Was the last kick. Humphrey. Oh, that's handball! David Lee. So here goes Andy Gray. And Besant, who saved the penalty on Saturday, couldn't stop Gray here. So, Humphrey gets the better of him. It's over, Johnson. And Wright is past him. Oh, it's a superb goal from Ian Wright. Here we go. Deflected. 2-1. Dorigo taking the responsibility here. And it flicked off Eric Young. Sanson, now Sinton, and was a hand used in there, and David Lee is making a habit of this, he's conceded another penalty, well spotted really by the referee, there, put his hand on the ball, Wegerle scores. Penalty. Townsend, and now they've got a penalty of their own. Parker's foul. It's going to be Kerry Dixon. So this for 1-1. Oh, he's missed it comprehensively. David Lee has taken up an intelligent position. It's not a bad cross either. Dixon has swept it in. Gabbiadini. Well, already we've seen a candidate for goal of the season. Wise is starting to torment Sunderland. In from Hall. Wilson. Chelsea are back in front. Will it be Townsend? Will it be Wise? It's Wise. Off the post. Well, Sunderland may have taken a strange route into the first division, but they've certainly shown already this season that they can pass the ball and they can entertain. And here's Kieran Brady, who's a very fine young player indeed, as he's just proved. Dixon, Wilson scurrying to the left. And all alone is Dennis Wise. Oh, blocked on the line off the inside of the post by Bennett. Still Wilson. Now, it's a penalty. Well, that looked very much on the harsh side, but was Bennett pulling him back here? That's what the referee saw. And he ruled against Gary Bennett. Well, Wise has been hitting the posts all afternoon, it seems, but he hits the back of the net now.
There's little wrong with the home form, but away results need improving if Chelsea are to keep up with the early pace. Things aren't helped by the absence of Gordon Jury and Dennis Wise, especially with a visit to Highbury coming up.
Chelsea, well fancied by a number of experts to do particularly well this season. They've bought well, but they've got to defend here against Perry Groves. And a cross from Dixon, a header down from Merson, and a goal from Limpar! Merson Limpar busy making the run inside him. Tripped. David Lee the culprit. Penalty to Arsenal. And he sends Besant the wrong way. Well claimed by Seaman. And he didn't just settle for that. It's a great throw. And Rocastle has found Michael Thomas all on his own. Besant has held Arsenal up, but maybe only momentarily. It's number three, it's Merson. Well, it's time for all the tricks now. Oh, and Limpar refused the invitation to shoot, but Rocastle does. And Arsenal's position improves even further. Winterburn, just a little too casual. This is Dixon. And one for Chelsea, Kevin Wilson. And David Seaman was angry with the sloppy defending. It should be Coates, it isn't. Moncal! the goal is not going to count. Now Tony Cotton came off his line and there was some pushing in there, I think by a little Lassau in the end. Went over Dixon, there's Lassau, the number 11, backing into Cotton, and it was a bit of a sympathetic verdict for the goalkeeper there from the referee. And again, and White is onside this time. Owen Quinn might reach this one, looked a push to me by Erlend Jonsson, it's a penalty, and Chelsea, who have been cursed by penalty awards against them this season, would you believe it, this is the fifth penalty they've conceded in six games, and Mark Ward takes on the job for Manchester City with 31 minutes gone, and Besant went the right way and it had to be right in that bottom corner. It was. Chelsea are behind. Nicholas Lassau, Dixon wants a deep ball and he's got it. Kerry Dixon off the bar. Now Nicholas McAllister, Clark is there. And that still could have got in after lunging Brightwell. Manchester City being called upon to show their resilience with a bit of good fortune as well. Townsend, Nicholas, Dixon. And can Lee round it off? Wilson has done. 18 minutes to go. It's been a difficult road for Chelsea today. But they'll feel they're still on the right path. Dixon got in front of Brightwell. Lee made a nuisance of himself. And Wilson was free and scores for the third game in a row. A typically tidy finish from him. And City this time just didn't have enough defenders to go round. Wise. Now Lassau, the first time cross. Knocked away by Jones, but only back where it came from. Nicholas. Wilson! Saw something quickly, reacted to it, it was the head of Dixon, and Wilson is there for his second. Oh, it's Vinnie Jones, unmarked, past his old mate Dave Besant. Well, Chelsea really should be in a much more comfortable position, and it's level, Brian Deane. Really have been some terrific battles between these two sides in recent seasons, and this is shaping up to be another one. And Alan Shearer is away for Southampton and has scored. Clark, held up by Case, and Nicholas forward for Chelsea. Townsend has won it back. Dixon, Townsend again, and now Clark, clever play from him to make space for the shot. 1-1, Steve Clark for Chelsea. We're halfway through the first half. Andy Townsend made an important contribution here to get to the ball in the first place, then to take it on after Dixon seemed to have lost control. But lovely skill on the ball from Clark. Chelsea trying to respond to the exhortation from the manager. Wallace. Here's Letizier. Picked off by Moncao. And that's angled well for Dixon. An excellent early cross has produced a second for Chelsea. Kevin Wilson. Two minutes to go to half-time. It was a fine move. And Chelsea, who are well fancied to achieve something really meaningful this season, and if they play like this, well, put some money on them. Letizia's corner. Met on the fall by Neil Ruddock's volley. Clark then, but the referee didn't see it that way. Southampton could cash in. Shearer, Wallace, they've regained the lead at 3-2.
Get Cookie in more.
Dorigo got in quickly. Jury. He's got such acceleration. Oh, brought down by Russell Osman. Well, after all the protests, it's Dennis Wise. ...17 minutes to go. Another twist to the plot, perhaps. Wise scores, 3-3 now.
A timely equaliser from Dennis Wise. He's enjoying the big club atmosphere. And Wise is on the verge of an even bigger stage. His early form at Chelsea is rewarded with a reserve place in the England squad. Another boost for morale comes in the Rumbelows Cup with a thumping second round victory.
McAllister. Forward from Nicholas, helped on by Wilson. Walsall might have a problem here if Dixon can get the cross in, which he does! And Andy Townsend, right under the bar, heads Chelsea into the lead. Well, an awkward match on paper. And scoring first, Chelsea take a grip. Townsend. Townsend again! Fairly fluent. Andy Townsend 2, Chelsea 2. Now Dixon. And Wilson. It's all going Chelsea's way. 2 minutes to go to half-time. Townsend involved in the build-up this time. Dixon might have scored, pushed out by Green, and Wilson couldn't miss. Guided on by Dixon, who comes in again. Lee tries the shot, McAllister is still going, and Wilson was right on the line as well. Well, whose goal is it? McAllister in the side for the suspended Dennis Wise. Was it over the line? It might well have been. Off the bar, Dixon. He'll be feeling about time he got one. Wilson's header, but Dixon's goal. Chelsea having to keep their concentration and try and do the job properly here. And they've extended their lead. That's Gordon Jury. So, 6 up now on aggregate. Popped on by Dixon, steered in by Jury. Wise. Here comes Dixon! The fourth division side finding it hard to live with Chelsea at the moment. Well, it's gone a long way. Oh,
Clark is in trouble, and Rimmer has pitched a goal for Walsall. Dixon, he's away. Another goal to Chelsea's collection. And they're sticking to their task pretty professionally. Won the aggregate margin at the moment. And Dixon not finished yet. Lasso! 4-1 here, 9-1 on aggregate. And Kerry Dixon carrying too much clout down the right for Walsall to contend with. The goal for Lasso.
Back in the league, it's proving difficult to recapture that goal-scoring form.
Rigo winning that from Pierce's pass. The crowd appreciating the nuance in that. That's Jury, underside of the bar, back into play. Great strike. And Jury again. Get past Walker the second time. Was a thrilling attempt by Gordon Jury here, which really deserved a better fate. The ball rocketing back into play. Nicholls header, very important for the likes of Townsend to get a grip on midfield in these early stages. Rush, Barnes too alert for Nicholas, Beardsley, Barnes is in behind them, and Rush, Liverpool a goal up, 3 minutes gone. Staunton steering it forward. There's Barnes. Still Barnes. More problems for Chelsea. Nicol coming in. McAllister. Chelsea still keeping their heads up after that poor start to the game. Townsend claiming that was over the line. Grobbelaar hauled the ball back in. Andy Townsend, who got a famous winning goal here in his Norwich City days.
Bumstead, Jury might get away here, and he takes some catching. Chelsea flooding into the centre. Wise is there, and a goal for Graham Lasso. Five minutes gone. And Villa's proud recent defensive record is punctured by Lasso's follow-up after Jury had really led the way here. And Dennis Wise came in with great aggression to make sure that the chance really materialised. And Lasso saw that gap and planted the ball into it. Chelsea badly in need of goals, badly in need of a win. They're off to a good start.
Checking the league table, there are some familiar names at the top, while Chelsea are a disappointing 11. In the Rumbelows Cup, Portsmouth provide determined opposition and hold out for a 0-0 draw. In the replay, Chelsea show some character of their own.
Play on, it's a good advantage play too, because Portsmouth have scored. Mark Chamberlain. Chamberlain. from Clark. Oh, and spectacularly hooked back in by Whittingham. Chelsea have got to gamble now. And they've got one back. David Lee. Well, the supporters see some hope. Dixon with the touch. Lee with the goal, 2-1. Can Chelsea salvage a draw here? Townsend. Oh, they've got a penalty, surely. Foul by Butters. Dennis Wise trying to keep cool. Yes! 2-2, would you believe it? Here's Dorigo. An extraordinary finish. Chelsea have been outplayed for so much of the game. And now Wilson! Oh, he's won it for them! Final minute, Portsmouth are absolutely stunned by this. They were 2-0 up with 10 minutes still to play. And now, as we move into the last minute, incredibly, they're 3-2 down. Kevin Wilson for Chelsea in the nick of time.
A great comeback, but winning in the league is a different proposition.
Crook. Oh, they've let Gordon turn. Still Dale Gordon. Chelsea will be annoyed about the way that was scored. And Wise. Handball, was it? Is it a penalty? Yes. Says Vic Callum. This is what happened here. Ian Butterworth. Handball. 1-1. Dennis Wise. McGee takes it. Oh, that's an own goal! Off Peter Nicholas. McGee. Here's Cork. Gibson's in the centre. 2-0, and Wimbledon closing in on their first home win of the season. Wimbledon will be feeling that they should have had this sewn up long ago. Jury. What a scramble. Put in by Wilson. But the linesman is flagging. The Chelsea fans think they've seen a recovery similar to the one at Portsmouth recently in the Rumbelows League Cup. This goal is not going to count. There are two players in there behind the goalkeeper, both of them offside as Wilson puts the ball in.
A turnaround in league fortunes is needed to pull away from the bottom half of the table. Chelsea are 14th. Graham Roberts swaps the bridge for the Hawthorns and West Brom. As one of the old guard moves on, youngsters Graham Stewart and Damian Matthew are drafted in for a vital league game before a live TV audience.
We weren't doing very well in the league, and that's why I made one or two changes. That was when we put one or two of the younger players in. And that was pleasing because we were going to Man United, we were going in the Lions' den, and we put the younger players in. The younger players rose to the occasion.
Dixon, who has some good memories of playing here at Old Trafford. Indeed, Chelsea have done pretty well against Manchester United on this ground. Oh, and they've been given a present here. An amazing own goal by Gary Pallister. So good fortune at Old Trafford for Bobby Campbell's team again. Seeley could do absolutely nothing about it. He was completely taken by surprise. Well, Dennis Wise does play in some teasing balls and unsettles defenders like this. Lassau, that was a very smart turn indeed. Cut off by Bruce. But Chelsea hunting the ball in United territory. Townsend. Well, he might go all the way here. He has done. It's 2 to Chelsea. Well, it's been a strange start to the game, but Bobby Campbell is delighted. Very quiet match until the own goal. And now Chelsea have got 2 inside 5 minutes. And they deserve this for their willingness to stop United playing the ball about in their own half. And Townsend saw the gap and found it. In comes Pallister, pushed out by Besant. Wallace! That's more like it for Manchester United. Jury calling for the ball to be hit in his direction by Gareth Hall. It goes instead more towards Dixon. Seeley complaining. Wondering how and why Kerry Dixon was allowed to be first to a towering ball in from Gareth Hall. One back well by Matthew. That's a good try. Well, Bobby Campbell has always enjoyed giving the youngsters a chance to prove their worth in the first division. It's fine ball. This is Wallace. Manchester United positioning themselves in the centre. Oh, and Hughes! The cross took out the goalkeeper and Mark Hughes did the rest. Chelsea having lost a 2-goal lead. Stewart. And again. It's a penalty. Against Neil Webb, and Dennis Wise is getting in plenty of practice with the club that he joined this season. It's another high pressure kick for him. He hasn't failed Chelsea yet this season from the penalty spot. And he doesn't fail them here, although Seeley went the right way. Well, they've got the lead back with 14 minutes to go. Thanks to Dennis Wise, can they hang on to it this time?
A great result, and Chelsea in good shape for a tricky Rumbelows Cup tie at Oxford.
And it's Melville! That was finished off very well indeed. Now Townsend. Chelsea flooding into the centre. Jury! Here's Dixon. Wise, Oxford backpedalling, trying to summon all their reinforcements. Dixon can win it for Chelsea now. Jury. Lee's at the far post, and in comes Jury again! A double blast for Gordon Jury and Chelsea!
Next, visits from two London rivals, starting with Spurs.
Good tackle by Moncao. And that's A wonderful pass by Townsend. Kerry Dixon says thank you very much. Wise. Jury. Oh, it's going to be a goal for Johnny Bunstead. Well, Torstvedt wondering who's going to take it. Chelsea have certainly got enough players around the ball. But Wise would be the favourite. Oh, off the bar. Well, Gascoigne. Spurs really need him to produce his party piece. And he has done. Besson reached it, touched it, but couldn't save it. Away by Thomas. Met by Jury, all the way back and in. 3-1, Gordon Jury. Lineker, Besson comes. Oh, it's a penalty. Lineker has earned it, and now he'll take it. Oh, he's missed it! Maybe Besson's reputation helped him then. Stewart. It's a good response, this, from Tottenham. And Lineker, this time, has got it past the goalkeeper and under the crossbar. Tottenham not finished yet. Touched off by Dixon. Here's Stewart. Oh, Dixon against the post. McGoldrick to take the Palace corner. Besson can only flap it down. Thorn, and has got it through the crowd. Palace have struck here. Not picked up. Palace will be livid with that. Well, Chelsea lost 2-1 to Crystal Palace at Selhurst Park in the opening days of the season. And they're trying to turn it 2-1 their way here with Jury. He might just do it. He has, with the help of a wicked deflection off the unfortunate Richard Shaw.
Good wins over two of the leading pack there, and Chelsea are back in the top half of the table. The Zenith Cup defence gets off to a winning start at the expense of Swindon, and the run of form continues, starting with one of the games of the season at the baseball ground.
Dixon. So, trying to get in here. Well saved by Peter Shilton. So learning about the quality of the former England goalkeeper with the first real chance for Chelsea. Here's Jury against Nick Pickering and past him. And Kerry Dixon taps it in at the far post. The signs were there for Chelsea and now they have gone in front. And the thrust of Gordon Jury here was too much for Derby. And Dixon says thank you very much. Callahan's caught. Met by Wright. Harford is there. And he turns. Saunders! 1-1. Dixon, fine climb, a fine flick. Here's Stewart. Well hit, well held. Dorigo. Wise. And again, Dixon, Moncao. It comes to Jury. Really trying to overpower Peter Shilton at the near post, but he wasn't having any of that. Already an absorbing encounter with more than a fair share of goal mouth action. And maybe the chance of another goal. It's David Lee pushed out by Shilton. A goal indeed. Another for Dixon. Concerted Chelsea pressure. And David Lee might have felt that he would have scored. Shilton did very well to push it out, but he could only push it straight to Dixon. Jury, who's leading them a merry dance at the moment. Heber, trying to spur Derby County forward. He's trying initially to do too much. Right, but he's got caught out as well. And here comes Gareth Hall, and Chelsea have got another one. A deserved goal for Jury. But Derby really committing suicide then, collectively. Hebbard lost possession in his own half in the first place, and then it was Mark Wright. Moncao. This is Stewart. Jury. Oh, and an awkward bounce for Wright. And it must be another one for Chelsea, but who's going to claim it? Not Dixon this time. Well, there have been some catastrophic mistakes. Driven in by Sage, won by Harford, right. Retrieved on the far side for Derby by Callahan. Harford. And Hebbard, 3-2. Chelsea certainly looking unsettled at the back with Moncao's injury. And Saunders! Well, Derby were 3-1 down at half-time, but it's 3-3 now. Paul Williams, Saunders, Harford trying to come onto this one, and it's dropped for Mickle White, and Derby County incredibly are now in front, 4-3. What a turnaround. Harford, and what sort of character have Chelsea got in these circumstances? Stewart leading the way forward. Maybe their best bet is to go back to all-out attack with Jury. And Wise! It's 4-4. And where will it end? Derby had pushed too many players forward, and Wise was unmarked. Mickle White with the corner. Harford's winning a lot of headers. Able to claim it, and wanting to use it for good purpose for Chelsea here. And Jury is off and running once more, and throughout this match it's spelt trouble for Derby. Still Jury. Jury shot, Jury's goal! Derby 4, Chelsea 5. On my watch, 7 minutes left. And that's plenty long enough for Derby to come back again, but Chelsea have the upper hand once more thanks to Jury. Chelsea supporters are urging the referee to blow the final whistle. Dorigo scurrying forward, holding off Hebbard. Help on the left from Graham Stewart. and Lasso! That surely wraps it up for Chelsea. Well, you have to see it to believe it. With Derby crumble in stoppage time, a six for Chelsea from Graham Lasso. Derby County 4, Chelsea 6, it's all over. And what will the coaches make of that? The fans have loved it. Regis gets to it, that's Speedy. Off the line and over the line from Gallagher. Coventry have taken the lead here at Stamford Bridge. Can Chelsea come from behind? Dixon. Some Coventry confusion. Seized upon by Andy Townsend. It was a splendid shot in Chelsea's time of need. Dixon headed it into the heart of Coventry's defending and they rather got in each other's way, and then Wise teed it up for Townsend. Lasso. Stewart. Chelsea going for the kill. They lead. Dennis Wise.
Seven straight wins and Chelsea have shot up to sixth in the table. They're the form team at the moment. But next opponent's Leeds are no pushovers.
Strachan's corner. Oh, Sterling's free! And Chelsea have an inquest about that. So taken by Strachan. Up goes Chapman! Straight into the back of the net. Chapman trying to get under it. And he beat Johnson to it. Schott has the chance. Well blocked by Besant. Schott goes again. Oh, Townsend has presented it to Chapman for his second. Now Townsend winning it back for Chelsea. Wilson alongside him. And Chelsea have got a lot of players in the centre. Dixon is one of them and he scored. 3-1. Fine header. Chapman trying to be a provider this time. McAllister. And here's the substitute, Whitlow! What a way to announce his arrival! And it's found a way in! That might well have been an own goal! Priest, Black lets it run. Chelsea try and defend on the edge of the penalty area, but they can't stop the cross coming in. And Black! Makes it 2-0. 6 minutes to go, that settled it. Wilson. Away by Ratcliffe, not very far. Wilson linking up with Stewart! And that's a great goal for Kevin Wilson. Sheedy. Besson's missed it. Sharp didn't. Over Sharp. Oh, and Nevin's round the back. Own goal. Jason Cundy and Chelsea's unbeaten home record is being threatened here by Everton.
An unhappy run into the new year, and things go from bad to worse in the FA Cup. Oxford avenging their Rumbelows defeat with a shock third round win. In the league, it's still a case of mixed fortunes.
Dixon, nicely played to Graham Lassau. Plenty of movement about this Chelsea attack. Matthew, and a goal! Gordon Jury! Dixon, Matthew was going ahead of him. Dixon now looks to the right. Stewart. That's a great header. It's a double for Jury. Taken up by Gabbiadini. Chelsea have to retreat. Hours. And it's it. Colin Tosco. In the centre. Oh, he must score. Jury must. Oh, surely it's got to go in. Extraordinary scenes in the Sunderland goal area. Dixon really had an open goal. So too did Jury and Norman. Well, that was an heroic save. And there were others on hand to stop it crossing the line. Sunderland still lead somehow.
Once again, the luck's against Chelsea. After 23 games, they're in ninth position with 32 points. In the Rumbelows Cup quarter-final, it looks like the same old story. Missed chances.
A lot of Chelsea players in the centre. That's Townsend on his weaker foot. Lassau, the pressure is still on Tottenham. Oh, and the chances still keep coming, but they're not taking them. That was Dixon. Given away by Thomas. And there's a run on for Kerry Dixon here. He's got the better of Mabbott. But not of Torsvet, not quite. Lassau. Great acceleration to leave Terry Fenwick in his wake, and Dixon is in behind Fenwick as well. Lassau! Once more, they let Tottenham off. Well, Chelsea really should have been safely in the semi-finals by now, but it's still 0-0. Tottenham hanging, but by a thread! And that was Edinburgh off the line. And Graham Lassau curses his misfortune.
So we've gone out and we've played to our maximum and we've done very well at home. We've gone across to Spurs and I would have thought our Chelsea fans would have expected us to win because they expect us to win all the time. But the football experts wouldn't have given us much chance. But we've gone over there and we've played extremely well.
Dixon, great touch. Townsend marauding from midfield, and Chelsea have done what they should have done at Stamford Bridge. They've scored. They've taken a chance that was very well created. Brilliant work by Dixon after Jury had got the first header in. And Townsend rolled it past Torsvet just inside the far post. Against Gascoigne, what's going to happen here? Well, it deflects Chelsea's way. Townsend off the post. In comes Dixon. Well, Chelsea can see a semi-final now and maybe a Wembley place beyond that. It's going for them here at White Hart Lane. Off the inside of the post, back to Dixon, who was alive to the situation.
Chelsea, very good value for this. Particularly taking it over the two matches, and they've got a chance now to extend their margin of victory. That's a penalty. Edinburgh on Jury. Dennis Wise scores, celebrates, 3-0.
We were full of confidence, actually. We thought that we should have won at the Bridge, probably about 5-0. And I think on the night, 3-0 was a fair reflection.
A famous victory. And against the undefeated league leaders Arsenal, there's another one.
Winterburn. Stewart! Arsenal are behind. And Graham Stewart got to a misplaced header from Winterburn. And really threatens the unbeaten sequence. Winterburn only set it up, wrong-footing Seaman. And in went Stewart very bravely. It's only really Dixon to aim for. And Wise found him. Brought out by Lee Dixon. Well, he's put Arsenal back in trouble with Wise. Stewart. That's a marvellous ball to Damien Mathew. Kerry Dixon is in the middle. Mathew to Dixon. To the back of the net. Arsenal know they're beaten. Chelsea know they have a victory that's come their way in the second half. There's a minute to go. And Stewart, the scorer of the first, helped set up the second. Great play by Mathew, who didn't look for his first goal for the first team. Instead, gave it to the proven man. And Kerry Dixon didn't disappoint him or Chelsea. Campbell. And now Smith has got through and got one back. 2 minutes into stoppage time. Quinn has guided it down. Gary Megson has the chance. And Chelsea are behind. A rare goal from Megson. Pointed. Well, the conquerors of Arsenal not looking at their best here. And it's a second. David White. Manchester City easing up slightly. Comfortable they feel with this two-goal lead. McAllister pushed out, but not very far by Coton, and it's drilled back past him by Wise. 2-1. The goalkeeper annoyed.
Wise. Good save. Well, the break seemed to come from nothing really then for Chelsea. But Dennis Wise, who's got 10 goals this season, was quickly onto the ball as it dropped off Phelan. And a good shot, well saved.
Inconsistency still the problem. Recent victims Arsenal are battling for the title. Chelsea are stuck in mid-table. There's to be no repeat of last year's Zenith Cup triumph either. After extra time, Luton went on penalties. In the semi-final of the Rumbelows Cup, more disappointment.
That's a clever free kick from Sheffield Wednesday, one that Ron Atkinson works on a lot, and it's produced its reward. It's a goal from Peter Shurtleff. Hurst on the bust.
2-0 and Sheffield Wednesday. A surprise package here. Well, Sheffield Wednesday, first and foremost, determined not to give anything away, but wanting to take any opportunities that might come their way. Pearson, this prolific central defender. That might come for Palmer. Wilson! Well hit. Wise. Well, this won't be high on Chelsea's rating of great performances of the season. They haven't really been able to fight back from that disastrous home leg. Dorigo. No offside, Dixon, and Stewart scores from on the line. Well, it's such a great season for Sheffield Wednesday, on the verge now of a Wembley place in the Rumbelows League Cup, looking good for promotion as well. Oh, and Monkau has hesitated, and Paul Williams, the Londoner, has the final word for Sheffield Wednesday.
Time to bounce back, and Chelsea hold their own against high-class opposition.
Coming up to the 20-minute mark, Wise with the Chelsea corner. And Dixon with the flick off the fingertips of Torsvet, and Jury! Goal for Chelsea! No offside, it's Lineker. Brought down by Bessard, penalty. Bessard isn't impressed by the decision, and it was a late fall by Lineker. Well, he missed the penalty at Stamford Bridge, but Lineker scores here, 1-1. Manchester United have a very good record in London this season. Sharp's corner. Pallister. And now Hughes, can he turn? He can! And there was nothing Chelsea could do about it. Here's Jury. Leaving Phelan. Confronted by Donaghy. And Jury rips the shot past a protesting Seeley. Right on half-time. And that's the danger that a direct forward can pose. Dorigo. Here's Wise, Dorigo wants it back. Manchester United won an offside, but it's not given. Pallister was playing Dorigo on, and he's rounded it all off himself. Gary Pallister gave Manchester United the problem with his positioning, and Dorigo raced away. There were players in the centre, but he saw a gap and he found it. Deep corner from Sharp this time. Pallister's up, McClure! Two goals Chelsea have conceded from left-wing corners. Seeley stays on his line, Monkau! Chelsea 3, Manchester United 2. 5 minutes to go in this game of twists and turns. Is this going to be the winner?
That win makes Chelsea the first club to do the double over Manchester United. And with 10 games remaining, the Blues are up to 8th spot. Leaving Stamford Bridge, Peter Nicholas. He moves to Watford. The next league sequence begins at a revitalised Sheffield United.
Well, Chelsea rather making a meal of getting the ball away. Wilder's cross. Monkau back to Wilder again. Oh, Besant discomforted. No foul on him. Goal for Bryson. Touched off by Shearer to Wallace. This is where Southampton can be effective with the speed of Rodney Wallace. It's a good cross too, and Shearer cashes in on it. Wallace. Now McLaughlin. McLaughlin again. Oh, that's got to be a penalty. Well, Southampton in a great position to get a second goal, which might secure a much-needed 3 points. Letizia. Chelsea 0, Southampton 2. Taken by Strachan. And here's Chris White, allowed to line it up, and Carl Schott, I think, got the crucial touch. Schott's header. And Fackloff steered it past Besant. And where were the defenders? Brought away by McAllister, and he's overdone it. Moncal. Chelsea trying to lift their game and lift their spirits, and Graham Lassow has done exactly that. That's a terrific show of enterprise, just when Chelsea needed it. Regis. Get it back again, but not for long. Played, neatly by Coventry, Burrows. Here's Mickey Ginn. Sansom going with him. Oh, but Ginn didn't need any support.
That poor run of form means Chelsea stay in mid-table, along with fellow underachievers Spurs, Everton and Forest. The visit of Luton brings first-team debuts for youngsters Frank Sinclair and Andy Myers, and a tremendous display of fighting spirit.
Chelsea in trouble with Elstrup, and after four consecutive defeats, that's the last thing they wanted to happen. They're a goal down. Priest. No offside again. Elstrup got to it, Besant's out of his goal, and Sean Farrell is the scorer. Now Farrell, and Black coming in, it's three for Luton. This young Chelsea side, three goals down after 23 minutes. That's good work by Dickens. And now Stewart, and Lassow. Well, it's a start. 3-1. The determination of Alan Dickens, a crucial factor here. His head knocked down after the disastrous way this game has begun for Chelsea. Stewart shot beaten out by Chamberlain, but Graham Lassow on hand to score. Townsend takes it. And it's 3-2! Stewart! For the 10 men. Well, this is brave stuff from Bobby Campbell's kids. Besant acting as an outfield player, trying to bring Chelsea up to their full complement. But the sending off of Lassow hasn't proved to be a major handicap. And look at this. In goes Wise. And the referee has pointed for a penalty. A push by Johnson on Wise. Luton feel they're hard done by. Well, in Dennis Wise, Chelsea have a good man for the job. But he saved it, Alec Chamberlain. Wise again. It is 3-3. Cotty will have to fight for this one. Ebrill. And now Ratcliffe, and Cotty makes sure typical Cotty goal following in. Call. Here's Newell. Dixon. Oh, he's put it without looking for Nevin. And Ebrel, once, twice, goal, 2-0. Ratcliffe, Dickens, Dixon, he's hit it first time, gloriously! Oh, that's the way to make up for that mistake. And it's a different Chelsea now, full of vitality. Wise. Dixon can reach this and has got his second. 2-2. Jury. Dixon and a goal. Wise. After six matches without a win, this is much more like it from Chelsea, and Norwich have neglected Dixon again. And he makes space for the shot, not quite. But here comes Jury! Dixon! And Jury, straight from the goalkeeper! Jury, 3-0. Oh, Besson's lost it. And Tolston has just about got it in to give Norwich some consolation. The club has made it clear that these Forest players are playing for their cup final places, and Crosby is behind Sinclair. And here comes Roy Keane. Crowd love it when Pearce goes forward. And Gary Parker! There's space here behind the left back again, but Sinclair's recovered, although Crosby takes him on and slips past him. 3-0, Ian Wone! Townsend is caught out, and there really is no margin for error against this slick Nottingham Forest side. Pearce, here he comes again, and the passing is so precise, and Chelsea have no answer. That's Nigel Clough at the near post. And Townsend didn't deal at all decisively with the throw. Pearce playing almost exclusively as an attacker, and he's going to be a scorer now. 5 for Forest. Stuart Pearce has had a good look. And, oh, nothing going right for Chelsea, but everything for Nottingham Forest. 6-0, 2 for Pearce. Walker clips it over the top, and Keane's made a great burst, and he's just towed it past Besson as he came out. Roy Keane started it for Forest. He may well have finished it off here. Nottingham Forest 7, Chelsea 0.
The defence will have nightmares about that game, and there's little consolation in Chelsea staying above Forest in the league. Two pieces of news. John Bumstead is rewarded for his tireless service. He's granted a free transfer. Meanwhile, one of the new faces, Dennis Wise, gets an England call-up. A selection no one really expected, least of all the man himself.
I was on standby, yeah, and now I've just got into the England squad. I'm pleased. I'll just give it my best shot, to be honest, and see what happens from there. I was surprised. I think a few people was, but he's picked me and I'm pleased. It was that, really.
His best proves good enough. Wise scores the winning goal on a dream debut and silences the critics. Back in West London, it's all hands to the pump. There's no lack of encouragement.
How's everybody?
And no lack of preparation. The team are determined to make up for the Forest result at the expense of title-chasing Liverpool. And they do it in some style.
Gillespie. Dorigo for Chelsea. In recent years, Liverpool have usually had the edge over Chelsea at Anfield this season. It was a 2-0 win, but Chelsea regard that as one of their best performances of the entire year. And Stewart, and here is Jury with Dixon going in to the centre, and he reaches the cross and scores! Liverpool were cut apart. Kerry Dixon found the perfect header after Gordon Jury had supplied a superb cross. It's wonderful news for Chelsea and for Arsenal. Liverpool are behind. And it was very direct and very effective. Dorigo. This is Townsend. Dickens going in. It breaks for Liverpool. And suddenly Chelsea have to turn. And Mulby takes them on. And now he's out of position. And Gillespie and Staunton have played Jury onside. Dixon in the middle. And down goes Jury. It's a penalty! Foul by Houghton. Well, Gordon Jury, who made Dixon's goal, has set up a chance for Chelsea's second here, taking Houghton on, and Houghton's displeased at the decision, but it's given Dennis Wise the opportunity to add to Liverpool's troubles. Wise a scorer for England on Wednesday, and a scorer for Chelsea here. And it's all going wrong for Liverpool at Stamford Bridge. 31 minutes gone. Rammed in by Wise. Liverpool two down. Beardsley. Rush, can he turn? Or set up Speedy, who's punted into the corner. And Liverpool's first reaction is to get the ball back and get on with it. Burrows. Here's Rosenthal. Well, I'm sitting on the edge of my seat, and I'm sure you all are watching as well. Rosenthal trying to weave a spell here. It's in! Phenomenal goal! With 17 minutes left, delirium amongst the Liverpool supporters. Well, it's taken Liverpool a long time to light their fire at Stamford Bridge, but it's burning brightly at the moment. Moncal. Dixon. For Wise. Townsend's gone to the right, on the left is Jury, and that means problems for Liverpool.
excellent defending by Steve Staunton. Wise to take the corner. Chelsea looking to hit back. On his end, they have done! Kerry Dixon! Grobbelaar didn't get there. How dramatically it changes again. And Wise puts it onto Dixon's head. And Grobbelaar will be haunted by that. The near post corner, the goalkeeper got it wrong. There was a time when it looked as though Kerry Dixon was going to become an Arsenal player. He could hardly have done more towards Arsenal winning a championship if he'd been a member of their staff than what he's done today. And he may not be finished yet. Onside, Kevin Wilson. Jury's up with him. This could make sure of it for Chelsea from Jury! 3 minutes to go. 4 goals past Liverpool. The classic counter-attack, Liverpool overcommitted, Wilson very composed, Jury in the right place. And really, there can be no more suitable candidate for rounding off the Chelsea win that surely it must now be than Gordon Jury, who caused Liverpool no end of problems in the first half and has a goal for himself close to the end of the second.
A terrific result, and a high note for Bobby Campbell to end on. His retirement as team manager is announced. In future, he'll be assisting chairman Ken Bates in plans to redevelop Stamford Bridge. Before that, one last piece of business at Aston Villa.
Dixon. Oh, Jason Kandy! Great start for Chelsea. Time the corner is varied. Townsend crosses, but it's produced another goal. Stewart. Well worth the journey, they feel. Cowans angled on well by Cascarino, who takes his position in the centre and is unmarked. York. Options right and left. A penalty has been given to Aston Villa. And Chelsea aren't sure why. We might get a clue here. It looks perhaps for an untidy challenge on Tony Cascarino. Well, up steps David Platt at the end of the week in which he's turned down a move to Italy. And he scores! Aston Villa 2, Chelsea 2 on the last day of the season.
The final day standings. Chelsea finished 10th with 49 points from 38 games. A familiar name at the top of the scoring charts, Kerry Dixon. Gordon Jury and Dennis Wise contributed their fair share too. Not the best of seasons then, but there is cause for optimism. Over a full league campaign, Chelsea were the only side to get the better of champions Arsenal. Inconsistency has been a problem, but one thing is certain. Chelsea can live with the very best.
Thank you.
look out for the other great Chelsea videos from Telstar Video. Chelsea are back. Extensive highlights from Chelsea's great start to the 1989-90 season. Chelsea Zenith Cup winners. 90 minutes of action from Chelsea's successful road to Wembley in 1990.